Hey. All right. All right. So this is a game that I used to play when I was 10. Came out in 1995. And I've never seen like a lot of people play this online. Or I don't think I've ever seen anyone play this online. But it's pretty cool. It's all bad like FMV and I won't say the acting's bad, but I mean it's kind of funny because it's like all kind of low budget, and I think it's pretty cool. I mean, this is back in the heyday of where you know CD-ROMs could have video, and people are all excited about that, and so lots of computer games had video all over them. And this is no exception. This game is mostly full motion video, and they really, it seems like it's a huge budget game. So let's get into it. This is Star Wars Rebel Assault. Oh my God, wait. Okay, good. It looks like you guys can hear that. My headphones are off. I thought the sound wasn't working. I'll just let it go. It's Rebel Assault 2. The first Rebel Assault's pretty good too, but this is better. In retrospect, I think it's better. I mean, I guess like the first Rebel Assault's kind of like the classic. A lot of people don't really even talk about this one because they just kind of talk about the first one if they talk about any of them. I hope it's not too loud. I hope that you can hear me. I think I adjusted everything correctly. So anyway, I'm Patrick. Hi, how's it going? and I'm just gonna chill out with this game for a bit. Look at that. Look at that animation. Awesome. We're like on the Death Star somewhere. Or something. I don't know. No, this is after the Death Star got destroyed, actually, so we can't be on the Death Star. I'm trying to monitor the chat. But the way I have this set up, I might not do a very good job of that. I have the chat window right there in case anyone joins. I'm streaming. It says I'm streaming. All right.
You wanted to speak with me, Admiral. Ah, yes. Tell your men I want no slip-ups this time. The demonstration shall proceed flawlessly.
Uh-huh.
Am I understood?
Yes, of course, sir. They'll be ready.
Good. Carry on.
All right. Nice little shoe tap there. I don't know what that's about, really. I don't know. I mean, they're supposed to be space Nazis. I don't know how many space Nazis with British accents, right? I don't know where the shoe tap thing comes from, though.
The rebel fighters are in range, my lord. Sigma Squadron stands ready, awaiting your command.
Very well, Admiral. Engage the rebel.
Not James Earl Jones. I'm gonna say not James Earl Jones. Maybe it is James Earl Jones. Sounds a little bit different to me, though.
Nothing on my scanners, Commander.
Copy that. Gen to patrol. Doesn't seem to be anything out here.
I think this sector's secure. Let's take one more path and get back to base.
I hear you. And let's make it quick. I don't want to stay out here a second
longer than necessary. Let's make it quick.
What's the matter, Till? Don't tell me a hotshot pilot like you is afraid of the Dryden Triangle.
No. I'm not saying I believe in ghost ships or anything, but...
You've got to admit, there's been a lot of unexplained happenings in these parts for the last 40 years since the Battle of Dryden. I mean, how can so many...
Watch it!
Rebel control, emergency, we're under attack. Can you read us? Is anybody out there?
So the game actually ends up being a type of game. It's a shooter on rails. That's pretty much what this game is.
As you can see, Lord Vader, the units perform admirably. In fact, I think the whole project is
cool. It's almost a flight simulator, too.
Why, in a few years...
What I see, Admiral Song, is just another one of your endless tests. I will not be impressed until I have, under my command, the full power to crush the Rebel Alliance.
Okay. Ah ha 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 ha. That was just the intro. All right. So let's get going on this. Start game, standard pilot, and the Drayton Triangle. A little similar to another triangle that you guys might know about.
Can't make it out, Commander.
Hailing vessel, repeat your message. We read you, but you're breaking up.
Repeat, this cargo vessel Corellia Star. We are clear from the Imperial fighters.
Clear information is vital to the Alliance. The Empire has hidden my... new weapon. Darth Vader intends to destroy the Alliance.
Doesn't that guy...
Repeat your message, Corellia.
We're under control. We have no time. They're boarding us.
Okay, kid. Stay sharp. Watch your scanners for
I'm telling a friend
vessel.
About this.
Too late, they've already seen us.
I'm picking up a Womp Rat's nest of TIE fighters at 042 okay. Mark 3.
They're headed our way.
That's me. That's
Copy
the character
that.
We are.
Switch to attack mode.
That one guy we were talking to, whenever, I don't know, when I used to play this, like, as a kid, I always thought that guy looked a lot like the guy from Friends. Joey? Was that his name? I forget. Okay. So that's what this game is. Oh, I can't hold it down. Okay. I try to hold down the mouse, it doesn't work that way. Anyway, this game's pretty cool. It's really simple. You just rapidly click on all the targets, and you also have slight control over the angle that your ship is flying. So like, if I need to dodge out of the way, I can actually control that. But you just have to kill them as fast as possible, because they will shoot you really fast. Okay, I don't need to rapidly click that much, because it only takes one shot to get them, so. Alright. It takes a lot, it's really actually a pretty challenging game. It takes a lot of reflexes just to do this. More than you think. It's more challenging, I think, than... It's pretty tough, actually. They make it pretty tough. And this is only on the normal setting. I don't think I've ever been able to beat it on any harder setting than this. But I've played through this game, like, 2 times at least. Like, the whole thing. It's kind of a... It's awesome, because it's just like an interactive movie. Look, and look how we're getting closer to the planet. Like, that's cool. There's actually, like, a real movie plane in the background there. We're not just in a still spot in space. I can't shoot my... I've tried to shoot my friend. I can't do it. All right! Man, that was awesome. All right.
Good job, kid. Now let's go find that freighter.
Okay. Since I'm not sure this is gonna work, I'm going to... This is work? Oh god, what's happening?
Stay alert. We lost a patrol in this sector 3 days ago.
I've also got a funny feeling about those TIEs we encountered.
I know, me too. There's no way they could have gotten from the freighter...
Try to find me. Not sure it's working. Fuse Toast on Twitch.
Jeez, you farm boys will believe anything you hear.
Wait, I've got a fix on an emergency distress beacon. It's on a civilian channel. It might be the...
Oh! Uh-oh.
Where'd they come from? Everyone, do you copy? Are you all right?
I actually think the acting's pretty decent. I mean, it's like... It's... Whatever, it's like television acting from the 90s, you know? pretty good. I mean, I don't know what the budget of this game was, but it must have been big. For a video game, at least back then. Corellian Star. Alright. Oh man, this is so cool. Look at that. Wait. Message me in the thing. See if you can use the chat.
Post Alpha, report. All's clear, sir. Nothing here but sand leeches and claw mines. Good. Stay alert. Sensors tracked a rebel ship going down in this sector. They probably didn't survive, but you never know.
Yeah, right.
If you tell me, if you, I want to know if there's someone in here, like, that can use the chat. Sorry, with all this technical stuff, it's probably looking real, whatever. Who gives a crap? Okay, this is cool. So, I forgot actually how to do this. Alright. Come on. It, you know, the one thing about this game that doesn't, is not going to hold up, is, oh. Hold on. Alright, hold on just a sec, guys. I'm just gonna check something real quick. Okay. That's great. Okay, see? You're seeing me get your texts. Alright. Cool, thanks, Wes. Alright, let's see here. So I'm just gonna, I might come by today, but I'm basically, I was planning on doing this for a while today. So, I'm just gonna kind of chill out on Twitch for a while doing this. See if I can get any viewers. If anyone will join me in this awesome game. This is a game I never see anyone else playing, so it's like, I don't know, I just really want to share this game. If I'm gonna do something like a live stream on Twitch, like it should be, you know, these games that I think that are, oh crap, that are, don't get enough attention. Okay, let's see here. Come on! Damn it. Alright. I'm dead. The one thing about this part of the game is it gets way repetitive. I just remember the Stormtrooper sequence is like way too repetitive. But I like the little touches they do to make it more look more interactive. Like when you shoot at the walls, it actually like puts a mark there. I mean, they really went through the trouble of like making the whole thing look like a movie, which is awesome. Like it obviously doesn't look like a movie, but I mean, look at this. That's like a real live actor that's like what had to stand in all those positions. Like
there he is.
It's back when they thought the future of video games was making everything look like a movie. God, this is actually a tough part. I don't know if there's actually a recognizable pattern. Damn it. Okay. Look, it's a cover-based shooter before Gears of War. No! Aw, oh, damn it. This is gonna take a while. This is very early in the game. I don't know if I'm gonna. I would like to at least get to the next part here. Oh god. That didn't work at all. I gotta react quicker. A lot quicker. This is crazy. Okay. It looks like it takes them a second to get my to get a beat on me. Oh god. I was looking at the thing for. Oh my god. Yeah. What's your name? Oh yeah, Andromic 56. I can barely read that. My monitor, I have a second monitor set up, but it's like, and then also it's on a dark theme, so like your name almost, your color of your name almost blends in with the chat. Blarg blarg. Oh, this is cool. Cool, thanks Wes. Now I know it's working. Feel free to just hang out for a bit if you want or whatever or not, I don't care. Thanks, thank you. Alright, let's see here. Alright, there we go. I can't get past this part. Oh man. Ah. Alright, well watch me die. For the third time the same way. Oh no, an ad. Oh no, an ad. Oh no, an ad. Yeah, I guess those ads will play, huh? That's interesting that you were watching and then an ad played. All right. It's really warm in my room too, so like I'm really sweating. I don't. Cool. You're back. And I'm still at the same spot. Oh god. Oh man. Okay. Yes, I got past it. I think the game maybe got easier for a second there. It was like, it told me not to, it was like trying to make it easier on me because I was doing too bad. Alright, let's see, okay, this part's tough. Wait. Oh shit. Damn it. Finally, I can see it playing. All right. What do you think of the game? Have I showed you this before? Yeah, it's totally a shooter on rails. This is like the one, this is the worst part of the game. I mean, it looks cool, but this part doesn't quite work as well as the, most of the game is like in a spaceship. I don't know, I always like this one better than the first one. Everyone talks about, if anyone ever references like this series, they often just talk about the original, which is like also a shooter on rails, but it's not as like high budget as this one, because there's not actually like live action videos like this. So that's why I like this one. It's like they try to make the whole thing a movie. All right. I play this game a lot when I was like 10 years old. This is one of the games I would play just a ton. Yeah, totally. Now, if you type more, oh crap, I don't know if I'll be able to read it all. Damn it. But it's not gonna scroll up. Hold on just a sec. Let's see here. I'm gonna try to fix that. The last thing I see you typing is, I like the FMV though, and then I don't think it's gonna scroll up after that. I have a weird resolution on my other monitor, so it's... Oh crap. Okay, wait, hold on. Alright. Let's see here. Alright, taking a quick break here to do this. Alright. And then back into the game. And then we go Alt, Enter. Cool! Alright. No, don't abort mission. Ah, god! Okay. Okay, I fixed the chat thing, so... Okay. Oh god, this is really tough too. These... So, the game is into all these different types of mission. Like, the different types of missions are that standing, shooting one, flying a first-person view in a ship and shooting, and then these ones, which are really tough, where you actually kind of need a joystick, and I'm trying to control this with a very sensitive mouse. Oh, god. Where you're just... the whole point is just try to keep the ship from flying into walls. God. This game is really hard. I totally forgot how hard this game is. But at least it's fun to watch it, like... yes, I see la la la. Okay, the last thing I wrote, la la la. Can you see this? Yes. Alright. Gotta focus here. Let's see here. How's the sound level? So I don't... is the game too loud? Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Okay, here's a tough part. I don't know exactly where I'm supposed to go at this point. Oh god. No, oh, fuck. Oh god. Like, that makes me really tense. Whenever, like, these types of levels are the worst in this game. Oh god. It really is. You need a joystick and a mouse to play this game. Because you need to switch back and forth, kind of.
Did you hear something?
Oh.
I'm sure it's nothing important.
Yeah, it's nothing important. I don't know why they didn't hear anything about a guy trying to escape. Cool. Hey, when is everyone coming by? Let's see here. Oh. Okay, cool. Damn it. No. Really? Okay, well... No, your level's higher. Okay, cool. Awesome. Awesome, thank you. Alright, well, I guess I'm gonna try that again. Okay, good, I don't have to start the whole game again. That is a really intense... Oops. Alright. Let's see here. So yeah, like, the things I've been thinking about doing, I've like doing this and then a little bit of this. Like, I like the idea of just doing this. Like, I want to show people some games, but I also have been doing like I started doing a Doom building thing where like I'm live streaming just Doom building a level. Like, oh crap! And also I live streamed the editing too of the fight scene, which was really fun. That was cool. Oh god! Shit! I don't know how you're supposed to react to that! Damn it! I got... Now I'm almost dead. Can I get further? Come on, further, 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 further. It's like hard to see what the hell... Oh god damn it. It's like the same crash every time. Further, 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 further. Probably round 5, like normal. Okay, cool. Alright, thanks. Awesome. I want to try to do this for like an hour. Okay, so here comes a- wait, okay. So I'll try to describe it when I get to it. Let's see here. Oh god, 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 oh god. It's a lot of guesswork. That's what sucks about this part. All these parts. It's like, it's really hard to tell where the ship is positioned in the space. But here's the part where it's like, you kind of have to just- The camera itself does this swing over to the side, and it's hard to really anticipate the movement you're supposed to do. Okay. And I'm just as damaged as I was before. That's great. Oh god, I can't believe I liked this game. This game is really unfair. I mean, it's awesome to look at. It's a huge amount of reward. Because you get to watch these stupid videos. But,
I'm sure it's nothing important.
But it's a lot of challenge. Alright. Cool, are you guys going to do a retro fadcast? Just have to Dragon's Quest it and memorize everything. Yeah, Dragon's Quest. Oh yeah, that's exactly what it's like. I was like, what's Dragon's Quest? And I could now I remember. Yeah, it is a lot like Dragon's Quest, honestly. Like, except it's not that dumb. It's not that. It is kind of the same thing where it's like you're being rewarded by just watching awesome, cheesy, low budget videos. But yeah, that one's like, obviously, I know you're joking, but it's like, that one's, yeah, just like specifically timing. This one's like all these other really annoying things. like guess where this Millennium Falcon is in the space that is not actually there, like, on this moving, like, on this movie that we're projecting in front of you, like... Okay. Oh man. Anyway, this is a fucking cool game though. That's the thing. Like, it's tough and it's unfair and it's like there aren't enough games that came out that were like this. I want people to get back into FMV as a legitimate way to make games. Okay, come on. Yeah!
No! God damn it!
I started doing that one so good. Okay, come on, here we go. I've really been like working up a lot of momentum on my projects and stuff, so it's like I want to make sure I'm getting a lot of stuff done today, and then I'll come over to do a, like, retro fatcast or something. But you guys gotta do a live stream with me or something. I can't wait for that. I'm so looking forward to you guys doing a live stream. Any of you guys, like, I've been asking Scotty too if he wants to. I'm gonna ask Scotty if he wants to do a live stream. I've been kind of talking with him about the whole, like, YouTube stuff. Oh god, because he's doing that a lot. Okay. Oh shit. Oh my god. Okay. And the thing is, I think so.
Did you hear something?
I don't know what you. Oh, you
that's
think so? What?
Just some loose rock or something. I'm sure it's nothing important.
Anyway, feel free to tune out anytime, Wes. It's okay. Like, I know this isn't like super entertaining or whatever if you need to go do something too. But hang around as much as you want because this is cool. All right. But yeah, we all got to do a live stream. That'd be cool. I can't wait for that to happen. I was thinking it would be really cool if Scotty wanted to do it, because it'd be really fun to have Scotty along. I'm kind of wondering how many people we could get into one live stream. I want at least 3 people in a live stream. I think it's a good dynamic. Like, if we're going to be working our way through an adventure game. I know I don't want to make... I know, like, we don't want to make it exactly like Mostly Walking, but I really do like the format that they have. And, it doesn't even have to be an adventure game. I was thinking there's other games that actually would be pretty cool and pretty fun to do that are single-player games, that are basically, that it'd be fun to just have people along to comment and make decisions with, like Civilization or something like that. Oh crap, hold on, wait, I will read that in just a sec. Can I do it? Here we go. All right, this is the dumb part. This is where I really have no idea what it wants me to do. Yes! Never! Okay! Sort of. Oh god, I'm better off than I was. Oh god. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Damn it. Okay, all right, all right. All right, never mind.
Did you hear something?
I had to reload the page and watch and add again.
I'm sure it's
now people then know. Get away. A number of people then no one can get away. Yeah, exactly. 8 people? Cool. All right, well. Maybe I will make it past this part. What's cool about doing these live streams, at least, is it's a way to try to put on a show, but at the same time, don't have to archive it on my own computer. That's one thing I like. Like, you can really just do it as long as you want, and it doesn't matter. And then it's actually really easy to get this stuff on YouTube too. Let's see here. So a little trivia for people, or a little information for people. This game came out on CD-ROM in 1995 for both PC and Mac. And Mac, the reason it's significant to me that it came out for Mac is because I only played on Macs for like the first like 15 years of my life, because that's all my parents had. And so I could only play the games that Macs had. So this was one of the few games that Mac that actually came out on Mac. LucasArts games came out on Mac. That was the thing. Pretty much every LucasArts game came out on Mac. Oh god. Okay. Oh god. Yeah! Okay, got it. I did it. Oh god. There's stormtroopers on speeders. I texted Lauren too, in case he's wanted to check it out. Because, I don't know, Lawrence though, into Star Wars, it's like, I'm wondering if he ever even saw this game. Now I'm worried that the internet's not working. Say something if you're there, Wes. Okay. Oh. Yeah, we don't want too many people in our live stream because we do want people to be able to get a word in. But there's so many people that we know that are would be fun to have a live stream with. Oh, come on. Damn it. I was supposed to take that out. Oh, cool. You saw it. I see you said nice. Awesome. Oh, God. Oh, God. I'm glad the internet's still working. Okay, here we go. Stormtroopers on speeders. Okay. Oh God, pull up. So here's a weird part because you're shooting and you're directing your ship. So this is what most of the game is like, where you have to like point the thing to dodge like this. And then you also have to shoot. These are the parts that I actually like. They're easier. Okay. Yeah! Okay, escaped on the Millennium Falcon. Well, it's a Corellian ship. It's not really the Millennium Falcon. Alright. I suck at this game. It took me a long time to get past that. I guess I'm really delayed. I'm senior. I'm saying... Yeah. That's so funny. You just said I'm saying things, and so that's how delayed this is. It's very delayed. I'm realizing that right now. Oh look, they're totally ripping off a shot from, that's just a shot straight out of Empire.
Your report, Admiral Son. I trust the operation is proceeding as planned.
Yes, Lord Vader. The field tests have been completed. In 12 hours, a fleet will stand ready at Imdar Alpha, where they'll be poised to lay waste to the rebels.
Then I will look forward to witnessing our victory. Make way to Imdar Alpha.
As you command, my lord.
Okay, that's pretty awesome. They totally intercut that with, like new footage with the original with the Empire Strikes Back movie.
Okay. We have recovered the mission recorders from the Corellian cargo vessel. We can now replay the full distress message sent from its pilot during the attack. If you'll observe.
We've discovered information that's vital to the Alliance. The Empire has a
So this guy I think looks like the the guy from Friends.
Whatever it is, Darth Vader intends to use it to destroy the Alliance. Hurry, Rebel Patrol, we haven't much time. They're boarding us.
Ah! I'm placing the fleet dispatching a strike team to the Dryden Nebula. Its mission
is to
investigate the Belt of Ara.
It's a trap.
Find the Imperial Complex and disable its production capacity.
It's a trap.
Fighters. And may the Force be with you.
Oh, I see a piece of dust on my screen. Oh, I can't clean it right now. All right.
Strike team, this is Rascal 1. Check in.
Rascal 2, standing by.
Rascal 3, standing by.
Good. Keep information. The perimeter is littered with beryllium mines. We'll have to wind our way through the asteroids and blast any mines we encounter.
It might get a little rough. But any easier, then it just wouldn't be any fun.
Copy that, Ace. We're with you.
All right, here we go. This is tough. There's a lot of dodging involved in this. Oh god.
Yeah.
It's a lot of guesswork too, because like you're not exact. You're watching a movie, and it's really tough to get a spatial awareness. Okay. It's like, how big are some of these asteroids? Okay. You can't really easily tell how big they are, so you can't really easily tell how close you are to them. Okay, here we go. It's pretty good, though. I mean, I've been doing okay here. Now, okay, so here's an interesting thing. This is why I like the Old Republic, that MMO that came out. It's because they actually ripped off this gameplay for their space missions. They have spaceflight missions that are exactly like Rebel Assault. And it's awesome. As like, there needs to be more games like this. Just simple on-rail shooters. Where all you have to do is like, dodge a little bit and shoot. Okay, and it's like a roller coaster. Okay. Okay. I just saw you say you said something else. I'll read it in just a sec. It's gotta go. I gotta focus. Awesome. Thanks for hanging out with me. This is cool. I have a Twitch viewer, and it's Wes. All right. All right. Oh, man. Oh, God. Ugh. Oh god, oh god! No! Oh, good, okay, I thought I died. Alrighty.
Yeah, thanks, Merrick, I had a ball.
Palane, Palane, password Palane. Oh, they give you passwords. It's like Metroid-style save games.
Okay, we've broken through the outer perimeter.
Okay, okay, it keeps stopping to load, okay.
But here comes the entertainment. I read a whole swarm of Thai interceptors.
You know, one thing I like about Twitch is that it's actually, this is a lower bitrate compared to what I usually broadcast on YouTube. I'm not sure which one would work better. I'm going to be testing out YouTube live streams too again. But YouTube does higher quality than Twitch. But what's good is, like, it's maybe easier for you to watch the Twitch stuff because people with lower internet speeds, I mean, because... because Twitch only broadcasts at a maximum of 3,500 bitrate, and that's low. Yeah. The reason I keep the quality up, like, I don't know what the quality looks like to you, but it should be okay, because instead of doing 60 frames a second, I'm only doing 30 frames a second. And that's like, so it gives the illusion of it being twice the quality in a sense, because it only has to do half the amount of frames. In a game like this, it really doesn't matter. That it would, you wouldn't want it to be 60 frames a second. Because this game is only at like 24 frames a second.
I'm gonna pulse a 026. Draw them into your line of fire.
Alright. I gotta remember, I don't really need to click my mouse that much. All I gotta do is point once and click. Just make sure it's locked on. Oh, look to it once. Do you see that? Bam! Got him. Man, it's like I'm in Star Wars. It's really cool. I mean, they really go out of their way to try to make it like you're in the movie.
Good shooting. Chalk another one for him.
There's one on my tail.
Got
lock.
Thanks,
Reese. save me from becoming space debris.
Just doing my job. Besides, I try not to litter.
Cool. I got your text, Dad. This is Rebel Assault. It's one of my favorite games. I played a lot when I was like 10 years old.
Structure on one of the asteroids ahead.
It's all like a movie.
It looks like
and a roller coaster
kind of
and like a shooter.
Implant.
But it's bigger than anything I've ever seen before. Arm your laser turrets. Follow me.
We'll take out the cooling system. Without it, the reactor will go critical.
Hopefully, after we've gotten out. We're in the transport corridor.
Ooh.
We're coming up on an exchange junction. Shoot out the shield.
Oh god, oh god.
We'll take it up into the core.
There's little stormtroopers I could shoot there. Alright, alright. Gotta take out all those. Okay. Oh. Dodge. Okay. Oh. Awesome. As long as the quality is good. Yeah, I think it helps that I'm only doing 30 frames a second. You can do that with these old games. You can get away with that with these old games. Okay. Damn it. So the whole thing here that's happening here in this part of the game is, look at those little stormtroopers. for bonus points, you can get those. We're on one video loop where the ships are just flying around in a circle. And once I clear all the, once I finally hit all of the shield generators for that one shield that looks all blue, then the game will go on to the next part where we go into this thing. But it's kind of cool how they keep it pretty seamless. Like, this is just a video loop. But it looks pretty seamless. Like, you can't really tell at first that it's just looping over and over again. Okay. Gotta get both of them. Okay, got it. All right.
Watch out for sentry guns. They take out any floating debris. That includes us.
Okay.
Watch out for that excavator.
Oh god.
Take out those blasters.
Okay, oh god. I heard another text. You have to sign in. Yeah. Yeah, Wes had that issue too. Yeah, you have to make an account and sign in to be able to get into the chat. All right. What's really cool about this type of game, god damn it. What's really cool about this type of game, I wish they would just make these games more, because now with today's like technology, like they could do some real cool stuff, but like the games industry just doesn't even want to try this kind of stuff anymore because it's hard. I mean, they're trying to do something that Hollywood does, but on a much lower budget and, you know, making it all look like a movie. With actors and, you know, CG and like pre-rendered computer graphics and everything. But it really pays off. It's just like, you know, this game probably didn't sell nearly as well as it needed to make back its money. You know, and they spent a ton of money on this game, obviously. And this was back in 1995. Okay. Oh god. I lost.
Isn't he behind you?
Let's try that again. Alright, start game, standard pilot, the mining facility. This is a fun part. I really do like this level. This is the most fun level so far. It's challenging, but it's not like annoying. Like some of those early levels are really bad, actually. I couldn't remember. I didn't remember like how like really annoying some of those early levels were.
But it's bigger than anything I've ever seen before. Arm your laser turrets. Follow me.
We'll take out the cooling system. Without it, the reactor will go critical.
Hopefully, after we've gotten out.
Yeah, I just wish they like. I don't know, like a Hollywood studio needs to join with a game studio to do something like this again, but make it look really good, like HD and awesome. Okay. FMV games, just full motion video games, just are not the popular thing to do anymore. It's kind of funny that they used to call them full motion video games, because like, there was video in certain games before, but, like, it was all extremely choppy, and something like this was called, like, full motion video because, you know, like, CD-ROMs were coming out for the first time, and, you know, you could put, like, video that actually looks like real video on a on something like a CD-ROM. And like now we look at this and it's like, this is like, what, 15 frames a second or something? I don't know what, it looks slower than a normal movie speed. Whatever the frame rate is, it's so slow. I keep missing those stormtroopers. They don't seem very, those stormtroopers like, they're just walking back and forth. They're not running. They're just walking. It's like they're not very concerned with what's going on around them. Ba-ba. Here they are, here they are. Stormtroopers, got them! Got all of them. Alright, got in there. One again. See how long I can handle this.
Watch out for sentry guns. They take out any floating debris. That includes us.
Oh god. Damn it, it's like so hard to. How do I dodge correctly there? Okay, and then I go down. Oh, okay. See, okay. I'm shooting more than I'm dodging. Should be dodging more than I'm shooting. Damn it. I just can't. Man, I really have to get better at that part. Oh, really? Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on here. Oh, man. Alright. Come on. There we go. Start game. Standard pilot. Mining facility. Alright, well, at least I'm going to have a chance to get really good at this part. Oops. Got it.
Watch out for sentry guns. They take out any floating debris. That includes us.
Hey, maybe we could do a live retro Fatcast somehow tonight. We can figure out a way to play that video, but live on the internet. Okay. Oh, crap. Man. Alright. Alright, later, Wes. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for helping out.
Watch out for sentry guns. They take out any floating debris. That includes us.
Really? Oh god, this is like so tough. Okay. I just can't get past that part. Okay, one more try. I gotta really focus here.
Watch out for sentry guns. They take out any floating debris.
This is actually a fun part. This is a part that's really hard and challenging, but actually really fun. Right here. But I gotta really make sure I'm dodging correctly here. Okay. Watch out for the fuck. Okay. There we go. Oh. No. Oh, come on. Oh, man. Come on. Yeah! Alright, did it. Went in there. Okay, I'm almost dead though. Alright, there we go. Total Star Wars goodness right there.
Good shooting, team. Okay, let's go home. Preparing for hyperspace.
Transferring coordinates from the nav computer.
Oh no!
Ah!
Analysis of these flight recordings has identified the attackers as modified V-38 assault fighters. These particular craft have a capability previously unheard of for ships their size. The ability to evade sensors and scanners,
rendering
them effectively invisible.
And the myths about the Dryden Triangle made a perfect cover for their tests.
Obviously, with a fleet of such vessels, Darth Vader could devastate our forces with near impunity.
So I think I'm going to call it for today.
Where he'll make his next move. For weeks, our intelligence has reported unusually high levels of Imperial fleet activity here, in the vicinity of the planet Imdar and its moon. The command ship Terror is en route to Imdar, where it will likely deploy a full wing of the Phantom V-38s. We have, however, a plan to stop them. A pilot has volunteered to rendezvous with our agent on the planet's surface.
So cool he got that guy.
We'll infiltrate the planetary supply
the
Terror and retrieve one of the Phantom ships for study.
That costume looks pretty legit.
Countermeasures can be found before it's too late. Rookie One, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Good. Report to Ops. May the Force be with you.
Rookie One. I don't know why he's called that.
This is Rebel Control. Begin when ready.
TIE training, alright.
Okay.
Alright, here we go. Listen to that music.
Admiral Crane. Due to the importance of this mission, I'm training you myself. Stay alert.
I copy. Should be just like back home.
Don't be getting cocky on me, kid.
You're doing okay, but you're not in a fancy X-Wing fighter anymore. These are standard class Imperial TIE fighters, and there's a reason why we haven't captured too many of these intact. They don't have shields, so they can't take much abuse.
If you're gonna make it through okay, you gotta learn to think like the Imperial bucketheads. Just follow my lead.
The Imperial what?
Now keep low up here. Good. Now just do as I do.
All right. Oh god. All right. Well, I'm gonna call it there for now. I might be doing another live stream later today, but for this game, that's gonna be it until maybe. I don't know. Maybe I'll do more of this game later. But this was fun. And if you saw this, thanks for watching. All right. Take it easy, everyone. Let's see here. Check out Doom Building. My Doom Building show. All right, later.